In the past week, we have seen a very small article appeared in Italian newspaper after we attacked or we openly went for Mr. DL. Again, immediately translated by him into English. This rogue writer has will stand his own position. We are people in Italy, I've spoken with the newspaper. The newspaper has set the full liability for such a what we call malicious attack without ground. Keshe Foundation Italy is a company limited and we stand for full damages. Thank you very much for your article. We will let you know the outcome of this attack, which was that we gave patches to the people in need at the time of disaster. They call it as a scam, but don't think they forgot that the patches and the pain pads are the same thing and we have a license on it. So they have in a way created a finance for the foundation by writing such a rogue letter, and the editors of the newspaper have accepted liability for the journalists. It's for them to do whatever they do with the journalists, but it has opened up the operation of paedophiles in a deeper way across Europe. There is something, as you come here every week, you come to learn, you come to learn about the science, and every now and then we get involved without us wanting to. For us being such a well-known organization, we get targeted by groups for their benefit. A lot of you are new to the Keshe Foundation, but the Keshe Foundation was targeted more or less 15 years ago by the paedophile groups at the highest level in the best well-organized country for paedophilia, which is Belgium. We did not know that the Keshe Foundation at that time, very few of us, were delivered in the hand of the most notorious paedophile. It took a lot of work for us to separate from this person. It took us a lot of damages to separate from this person. But in the process, we went back about 2 or 3 years ago, looking at everyone which this person brought into the foundation and see their connections. And we realize one by one, every person who's come in touch with the foundation through his time, they're all connected to paedophile group. At the beginning, they wrote articles, why is he attacking paedophiles? We bring science to protect man, and when we have a knowledge to protect man, we have to share it. We saw when exactly 2 years ago, we opened the hand of Sterling. Everybody told us, why is he doing this? We saw the outcome 2 months later, exactly a year ago. Sterling confessed to raping his own daughters. We saw then on the back of it, 70,000 paedophile group opened up with Interpol. The files were totally opened up. Are we there, Rick? Can you hear me?
Yes, Mr. Keshe. Yeah.
Then we saw on the back of that 70,000 files, 4,000 paedophiles were arrested and everything else in the past 6 months. We saw by that arrest the death of one of the senior judges which was protecting Sterling. We saw how once we start attacking Sterling, when we found out what he was up to, one of his, the guy who brought this guy into the foundation, went to his support, another journalist. He called himself journalist, journalist of death of children, rape of children, called Sterling. We took a lot. Keshe Foundation members took a lot. But we did not stop. We carry on teaching. You saw me some few months ago. I went in one of my teaching praising DL, and a lot of people went, why is he doing this? We work closely, very closely with international security police forces. What we do is what the psychologists and the pattern officers of the psychology of pattern of the criminals advise us. We work on a work pattern, the way we did with Sterling. If you remember, on the 14th of last year, 14th of February, 15th of February, the senior judge in the United States was killed or whatever, which was connected to Sterling. But they could not get a Sterling because there was no confession without taking years. With the arrangement between Keshe Foundation, FBI and CIA, we went on a public conference, very rapidly organized, as we all know, with Kerry Cassidy. And in that short sentence, we explained we know the victims and are his children. 24 hours later, he walked into the police station, handed over him to the police, confessed to all the rapes he's done of the children, and the only thing could have been done was to have somebody physically, which it could be done immediately. And he offered his two daughters as victims. You have to understand that he, to be separated from family, he went through a public divorce and he put a picture of himself with a crack between the picture with himself and his wife. Then he showed that the wife was fully aware of what he's doing, and it was more or less a collaboration of silence. We had to look into this. We could see patterns. Security people see patterns. We looked into the pattern of a guy called The True. Go on the Belgium news, you see who he is. He is a convicted serial paedophile killer of children, especially girls. This guy appears at about the same time as DL, when and around that time. There was, and there is a huge suspicion in the Belgian press that he's connected at a high level, that's why The True was called protected. In fact, DL is part of that protecting organization. A lot of you don't know the background about him. He worked as a highest level civil servant within the office of the Prime Minister of Belgium. And at the same time, he is, according to his own declaration, has connected with the wealthy families, as his father has built many buildings of diamond bourse of Antwerp. We could not understand, we could not find a track. 2 weeks ago, on a pre-planned organization with securities, we went on explaining in an open way, without targeting anyone, about paedophiles, how asking for a picture of the children. None of you went to write about it, because it's none of you. None of you are paedophiles. None of you target children and put things on the internet to collect children. The one who does felt scared. He had to respond. And we were counting on this. Security services were counting on his response. The response came in a strange way at what is known as MT Keshe, facts about Mehran T Keshe. In that part, in his daily criticism of the Keshe Foundation, because he knows he started writing these when we were on track with what we saw last year. We started that we knew Sterling has raped his own children, is the pattern of the people who support people like this. So they must be part of it, and they've done the same. I went directly for openly, without talking about anyone in person, explaining how they are putting advertising on the internet, looking for six-year-old children, putting the pictures, and taking pictures of them, and the children disappear in more or less hypnotism. None of you wrote anything about this because you are not criminals, but those who are affected write because they see they could have been found out, now we muddy up the water. We watch, we monitor, we were waiting for response. The response came and the confession came. Now we have a full proof that the L is in child trafficking. With his own admission in facts about Keshe Foundation, or facts about Mehran T Keshe. Please, some of you been on it, if you haven't been on it, go on it. This is what the security services were waiting for. I'll read it to you. It's very, very simple. He wrote, because he knew it's him, he had to defend himself something. None of you went to defend yourself. He wrote in his blog against Mehran T Keshe the following, that my blah blah puzzle were given in 1991 for production, commercial license to a new company. Don't forget, The True was captured around 1991, 92, 96 for raping children. At the time, I was CEO and a major shareholder of the company. In 2002, I left the company. Do not forget that 2002 was when one of the most senior scientists, developers of compression technology, was murdered. And then the technology appeared in the hand of DL. Now we understand. Thus, there was a switch of CEO. I no longer have shares in that company, and I'm no longer involved business-wise. Not even involved in any marketing. But, this is what we were looking for. But, only in the same aspects, but only in some aspects of research and development. Researching new product to capture children. So, for the first time, he has confessed he's involved in operation of the company. He says he had nothing to do. But the company has been sold inside, it's never sold. The biggest point for us was this paragraph. He writes in Keshe Foundation, facts about Mehran T Keshe. Have you heard of the story called The Tale of Unexpected? This is The Tale of Unexpected. The man shot himself in his foot. In this paragraph he writes, in 2015-2016, the CEO and the marketing manager decided to organize a marketing photo shoot for new promotional materials and packaging. For these photos, some children playing with a blah blah were needed. My blah 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 marketing manager connected via Facebook with her friends, parents of young children. This is in bracket, parents of young children, please be heard, and ask for help. The paragraph goes, free cinema tickets were promised to the parents when they let the puzzle company take pictures of their kids with my puzzle, and the kids' parents were of course always present, where I was not present at all. You don't need to defend yourself if you're not a criminal. This is a negative psychology which has declared himself to be a paedophile. Interesting enough, we would like you to go on a website, on a channel which is set up by backup of security services. It reads very easy. The facts about Dirk. We advise you to go on it. What we advise you to do when you go on the facts, this has nothing to do with me. This site is set exactly the same as he has set his blog. In this link, you see something very, very strange. And this is that Mr. Paedophile, in his admission in the Keshe Foundation blog, he says, in 2015-2016, the CEO and the marketing manager decided to organize a marketing photo about. We went with our people, we found the Facebook with friends. This is not a private, this is an advertising looking for children. And strange enough, it's 14th of June 2014. This is an annual event collecting children with this organization of the DL. Then the security people start looking into the advertising. He says on the Facebook with some friends. This is a proper brochure put out on the internet looking for children. You can see it and you can read it. It's in Flemish. It is translated into English by people that you understand exactly what it says. The translation of this to be supposedly what you call Facebook friends between friends is very, very simple. If you don't have it, it's been placed on the site. It's a very, very simple translation. The CEO has asked for something very simple, and that is supposed to be, we are looking for your children, the picture of the children, and very, very specific. The full translation reads as follows. Wanted, cheerful children and adults for photo shoot for blah blah products, ages put in. Don't forget they have to put all ages that they can use as decoy. Date is given, place is given, and interesting reads the following. Location, the province of Antwerp, not on business location, precise location will be announced later. Now, the interesting thing is, it says, they give a cinema ticket and one professional photo. But, don't get fooled, go further down the line of the advertising. Telephone number is given and everything else. Now you can call the company and bombard them. Why and where are your children? We haven't published this. This is in the public domain. Nothing to do with us. But what is interesting at the bottom, the last deviancy of research and development, is research how you can get children reads your name, your date of birth, two photo of yourself, whose first full body pictures. If you are advertising for anybody to have a happy time, why do you look for children's full body pictures? Pre-sold before arriving for a photo. Interesting is, what is puzzling the security people is, when you look at the pictures as placed for this, they've asked for a full picture of children. But the unhappiness about it is, children are flat on the belly. Or they are showing the size of their foot. Is this how you take picture of the full body and the face? Why do you need to use these positions? So, we see, we are dealing with a professional paedophile, using every means to get as much as he can. You don't put free ticket, and you don't show the feet of the children, lying down, flat, on their belly, flat. This is the position which paedophiles rape children. They say, we see in other entries of DL, he talks about fetish. Go to a website which you cannot find, but is obscurely in archives of the world internet system called Hollywood.org. A lot of cleaning up has been going on by DL trying to wipe out any track, but you cannot wipe out what is on the archives. Interesting in the archives, he talks about fetish. He talks about hypnotism. He's got a section. We see the pattern of the work. A criminal paedophile, serial paedophile. The question is, how come they use their children to protect and bring more for them? Don't forget, the title of the advertising says, wanted. You've seen how they put on the list of criminals around the world on the internet, wanted. They are headhunting for children. They ask for two photos of yourself. First, full body. They want to see if they can sell the child. We're not making any accusation. Is what they have put it and been working on. Please give the recording of this teaching to the police. The police needs to be educated in your area and ask them for the arrest of this man. He is one of the top godfathers of paedophile groups. Strange enough, if you look along, we have not seen anything. The website about facts about Dirk does not accuse anything, does not write anything wrong about DL. It writes his natural mental process. We see drawings which takes hours and hours to do. Only one shape is in the head of the man, genital of the man. You've seen rows of condoms. How many, why these condoms have been put there, and so immaculately one by one has been used on one child and hung, bringing back memory of which child he has abused. Have you ever thought of that? I think it's about 60 of them. So we are looking for 60 children. You can put one or two condoms, not 50, 60 on the long row. It means everything. You keep what is precious to you and has a good memory. Do you keep the cup from the girl you adopt, or you had a bad memory, we trade you? You keep a jewelry, a ring from the mother who left you a good memory and you want to keep it. These people are sick. They keep the condoms which they use for raping children. Just look at the numbers and count the children. One condom per child. Now you see why he's been writing so heavily since June, July, since we opened with the help of the security directly to him. We ask you, please take this section and submit it to the police. Why are these people looking? Why Mr. So Gooder is looking for a six-year-old child, and he is the head of research and development, researching ways to develop ways to capture more children, and then his own writing, not ours. I left the company, I am only in some aspects of R&D, some aspects which connects to children. Now you see why we've been attacked. Now you understand how DL works. We told you we keep silent. There is enough evidence for the whole family to be called in and explain why six-year-old children with a picture of them on a flat floor, the foot. Are you going to put a foot of a child on a something happily cubed? This shows a pattern. We saw the true went to prison with his wife. We saw Sterling connected to his wife and the children. Now you understand why such a vicious attack has been targeted on us. Because they knew we are into them. Sterling wrote heavily the last few days before his arrest. Now we give DL one option. Hand over yourself to the police. If you look on his writings, even the last one, he refers at the bottom, Interpol and the police is after him. I work on daily on the basis, even in Africa, sit with senior security police officers and Interpol. They laugh. I show them, do you have a warrant for me? He says, this guy is a cuckoo. Keshe Foundation is an international organization. We work with different nationalities. We work through different nationalities, and we know people, now we have come wise to, like the L, try to penetrate the foundation to benefit themselves or their activities. So we have set up a very secure system with number of security services, and internally we carry. We are one of the only, what we call, foundations who has an internal security force. When you send an application, we vet, we go through it. 90% we are okay, 10% try to cheat in and find in a way to do something. But our work, all our findings, is shared with national securities on a daily basis. So, it's very interesting. The man's fear was to be arrested by Interpol, and he writes it, because he knows he's on the verge. what is interesting, we said that he is involved in hypnotism. He's been everywhere, deleting everything. The amount you see he writes about me, he's spending 10 times more going on everywhere on the internet, cleaning up. He has cleaned up a lot. But unfortunately, some archives cannot be cleaned. In Hollywood.org, we found he talks and teaches about hypnotism and the effect of it. And in that writing, if you understand, which is unraveled by the security services psychological team, he talks about how he hypnotizes children and the principle behind it. It is on the link. Go and read it. Interesting enough, we come to another point in this dilemma with this, what we call paedophile. We told you he is heavily involved in killing scientists and stealing technology, and how we fell out with him was that when he went to China, trying to patent something in China to steal the Magrav system. And then by one of our sincere supporters, and now one of the senior management of the Keshe Foundation, Armin, he said in that meeting, what are you doing? We are not patenting anything. And the whole problem with us, with him started. But interesting enough, he's done this to everyone he's worked with. But on the same link, please look. It says a very nice thing. Read one of the writings in there, which is, have a look. This will enlighten you how this is a man with a lot of criminal records. He appears in paedophiles, he appears in killing of the scientists. But in one section of this interesting website, you see something very, very strange. It's a very small writing. It says, sportsman. This is on the internet. We are just copied, pasted down. I'll read it for you. We have copied it from this website, and I'm reading it because it's published by them, and it's on the archives of the internet. He says the translation is in Flemish. It is done 11 years ago. This is the time when we got to know this gentleman, more or less. Now he changed from compression to a new technology, a new scientist, a new murder. I was supposed to be done the same. We got to know him in 2005. Today is 2011, 6, 17, 11 years later, more or less. This is the guy which with him, they've done a lot of work in stealing compression technology and killing of a scientist, but they thought disappeared. He says, this is one of his closest friend who wrote the compression, and now he became his biggest enemy. He says the name, Dirk, you introduce yourself as a minister or a good friend of a minister, Verhofstadt. Now you know the high connection. He used to be a high-ranking civil servant, disappearing children was his job. Also, you introduce yourself. You have to understand, Verhofstadt was the Prime Minister of Belgium. Also, you introduce yourself as a press agent. You give also the impression that you are a doctor, or give and say you that you are a doctor. You are also a scientist. You also know about the profession niche of electronics. You know everything concerning compression. You know also everything concerning cosmos. You know also how cosmos has arisen. You know also everything concerning magic. You know also everything concerning science. You know also everything. You know and think that you know everything. And if you do not get right, you go in attack also, with false declaration and lies. You are simply a narcissist. Greeting. With a signature. But interesting enough is, when you click and read this, if you push it right enough, it says open the URL. You see how he's been involved in the compression immediately after killing of a scientist. $100 million the morning was supposed to be paid to the scientists. Scientist was found dead. Now, it's him, how they fight over the crumbs. This is not us, this is exactly about him and another person who he opened the forum to attack to destroy once his cover was opening up. You have to understand, there is a senior politicians in Belgium, a senior politician, that he went on attack trying to, and he found out about Paedophile organization. DL broke into him. And then he started setting up a political party. He was asked to make sure that the party dies. And the name of the scientist, the name of the politician, and everybody else, even the gentleman you see here, all one by one, being discredited by one man. Nobody else write bad about him or anything, except DL. He is a guy which is well protected by, as he says, Prime Minister. He used to be a civil servant, hypnotist. And then you understand, we don't make accusation. We did not do anything. We just waited till the gentleman hung himself, and he did. He has confessed. Now we understand lying and cheating in 2015-16, when actually they're still doing it in 2014. They've been doing it since 2002. Every year, children wanting a free picture, they ask for a full body picture and they disappear. Please take the recording of this and give it to your police stations, give it to your security services, and ask where are the children and which condom has which name on it, which is hanging on his pictures, on his artwork. We would like to put a lot of parents nightmare waiting for the door to be knocked and the child walking after 20, 30 years to put to bed. We are dealing with professional group. He immediately, knowing that is to be discovered, set up the Italian newspaper, which is virtually useless. The newspaper have already agreed that is absolutely, absolutely relevant. They have asked us to tell them the damages. By Italian law, you cannot write these kind of things. By Italian law, we are open to protect ourselves. So now he understand how he suddenly went and translating the whole article, because he initiated it, he wrote it. These are his agents. Sterling, Kumaran, now more and more. So what you see, we are dealing with a serial paedophile, which is hiding behind, as we saw with Sterling, with the Drew and the others like him, children. And he mentions who is the marketing manager. Interesting enough, very interesting enough, in what we know is going to be unraveled on this link, you will see him working connected directly with convicted paedophiles in Asia. These line of communication you see on the background of the writing of 11 years ago, it goes back in 2002, it goes back in 1980s and 90s. Now you understand why we stay quiet. We had to wait till he confesses, the way did Sterling. I have nothing to do with it, I sold it, I'm not the chairman, it was, yes, it was handed over to my, we know who. And then he says, I'm not involved, but R&D. If you're not involved after 20 years, you still are R&D. And then we see the rise of this new management. R&D came after my arrest and the payment of huge sum of money for him trying to get me killed. So, we see the pattern. Don't forget, this is all started because we said, he's pissing in the garden in front of a 2.5-year-old child. He's asking for 6-year-old children. My son was 2.5 years old. He likes girls of 6. Put them on the grass. And he says, the garden. So, he was, why isn't he doing anything in the house? He was doing it in the garden in front of my child. He has a fetish to rape children in the garden. This is his own writing. He published the picture of our holiday home in Belgium. That's not our residence, was our holiday home. And says, I was in the garden, and then we see the picture of children in the garden. The foot. We want the full body picture, but we show your foot for those who have footish fetish. And in Hollywood.com, he writes about fetish. Now you see the state of the mind of the man and who he is. Please cut this section out of the teaching. Give the evidence to the police. We can give you more because collectively we have to stop this man. We didn't write anything. He's done it himself. Now, it was the biggest problem for securities because he always denied to have anything to do with the company he set up for attracting children. Because the true gun, he was operating on a free hand. The problem is, the money changed. 1999, 2000. You sell one cube, you have to earn a few thousand. For thousands of cubes he has to sell. Now, as we read from the internet, lubrication was 100 million killing scientists. The compression, which is talked about here, yields billions. At the moment, it's a multi-billion. Compression, internet compression, is a huge business. And as we told you before, these companies are disappearing from here into Australia, Australia to Singapore, and the rest of it. Murdering scientists is his profession. I've been there 3 times near his house. Time's been shot at, blown up, and everything else. This is irrelevant. We have to protect our children. Now we see the source. How these people collectively advertise to bring children and they want a full-size picture, but we only show the foot. Or we show them on the belly. And it's a Facebook friends, but this is a brochure. This is a full brochure, technically designed, precisely positioned to attract children. The lying, writing so fast, trying to defend. A simple check on the Facebook he was not supposed to know is dated 14th June 2014. But he says in 2000, a new CEO 2015-16 has decided. So, we've all been at it for a long time. Now you understand. We are going to open up the facts about this man. I apologize from our followers who ever came in touch with such an evil man. We knew there was something wrong, but we couldn't put our hands on it till we moved into Italy. Till we saw the only person who knew how was poisoned, him calling a doctor saying he's been poisoned by arsenic. How do you know if you didn't do it on your initiative to another Belgium, John, in the Keshe Foundation? When the doctor came all the way from Western Europe to save my life, thank you for your work. Thank you for saving my life and my wife and my child. We have respect for you and what you've done for us. But on the other hand, how could somebody in Belgium know how I was poisoned? And the interesting is, while we were dying, he kept on calling, I have to come to Italy to see you. I have to be there. And Caroline said, he is murdering us. He doesn't put foot anywhere in Italy near us. How come he knew what we are poisoned with and antidote of it, saved our life, with him telling a doctor. He's conscious because he still couldn't get the key to the flight system. He needed to show he still can do what he likes. But goes back to one thing. Paedophile. Now we have opened the book. Now you can see. Now it is, we want the full size picture of your child, but we only show the top. And the picture is sold before it comes. Now you understand. Now you come here to teach about the science. You come here to learn how to make magravs and patches and everything else. But you forget one thing. What's the use of living when we cannot protect our children? Unless you're one of the Paedophiles. Unless you live with people like this. We did not choose this. He was planted inside the Keshe Foundation by most notorious Paedophile group in Belgium, which at that time we didn't know. We went to a scientific firm. So, please, we explain more and more about DL. He's his own writing. He's, we don't make any accusation. We just show you and explain the facts. My biggest concern is that line of condoms he has put. How many children's name we should put on it. I hope we find these children. I hope we find the ones he has touched. That we can put the family and the mothers and the fathers at peace. Now you understand. You know, criminals always keep something of the crime to, for them, remember the successful crime. This man keeps condoms of the children he's abused. Otherwise, no one ever go to publishing such a thing as art. What is interesting, when you look at this picture, when you look at so-called art and his mentality and putting young children's face on, looking to be a family man, is very simple. Some of you, you don't look, but as security officers, we have to look. If you look clearly and closely, you see something very strange with this man. All the condoms are used. I pray for the soul of the children who he has abused. Before their death, at least they might have found peace. Look at the picture above the line of condoms. You see nothing but penis. A man's psychological path is shape of penis. Sterling denied. This guy went to the extreme because he's a head top and he has a full protection of his masters. They sacrificed the top judge. Now he is disposable. Let him write. The more he writes about the fact about the Keshe Foundation, the more we break into his what it is. I would like to ask you one thing, sir, in writing about me. Can you write at least one place where you buried one of the children? If I can put the mind of one mother at peace, knowing the child is dead, she's not waiting for the next knock 50 years, 20 years, 30 years for the child to appear. We thank you for that. One child, no more. Don't call us. Repeat your picture of the condom and just put the name of the child on it. and we know. This is how you work, this is your mentality. And the link, as we said, look in, is not existing anymore, it's an archive of it, hollywood.com. And then you see he teaches hypnosis. That's how the children were killed. That's how even their own children can't remember, because when they're hypnotized, they can't remember a thing. But in the background, they're controlled. That they still organize picture photos, the children. Innocence of mind, innocence of thought never changes. I inform my team before we go open. You can take our websites down, you can go and attack our zones, you can write another, find another paedophile to write another article. The Keshe Foundation has grown beyond the imagination of anyone could think, because it's a correct science, is perfect science. Works for people if they understand the ways of it. You came to use my websites as a webmaster for attracting or taking data the way Sterling said. I have 40,000 visitors and 50% of them are paedophiles. So, for a while now we understand why he pushed to be webmaster. Because he could have access to a lot of things. And this is how he works. Go and look at the people he has attacked viciously, the same as us, across internet. Any of his victims have been attacked after he failed. One of the most famous politicians in Belgium. You see the other one here who shared the decompression with him. Then another guy, and then another guy. Then killing of the scientist. Murder of businessman where the money is involved. In one of and all his writing, he says, Keshe is hungry for the money and is doing this and that for the money. I live a life. I have no bank account except foundation account. I get a penny, goes through the accounts. We pay a penny, goes through the accounts. But interesting is, one of the richest men in Belgium with the Russian girl in bed was murdered and the house burned down, and all his talk at that time was about the money. There was a lot of cash in the house. How do you know if you're not involved? But the person who involved with it is another paedophile close friend of him, very close friend of him, which we had the misfortune of not knowing but introduced to. Deported from Thailand for raping a 10-year-old and a 12-year-old child boy. And this man spent many hours and days with him in his house in Antwerp. And we'll show you the files of their communication security services. I picked it up. And how the same man with him is involved in murdering of the scientists with 100 million contracts. The facts about Dirk opens up the facts about the Keshe, Mehran T Keshe. We are a perfect scientific organization. We, not me, I gave you the foundation. You have built the house. The house of knowledge belongs to you. I'm here just to open new line of thoughts. In him attacking me is attacking you. In him attacking us means the criminals think they are winning. Please do what we did. If the police wants to know, and we check through our security, these are real police officers in criminal organizations, then we release nearly 1 terabyte, roughly 2 terabytes of information we gathered on DL operation. Murders, how he's connected through high society in killing children, paedophilia. And very interesting, very, very interesting for us is how he has managed to get away with it so long. I think we have to put the truth to be the God of DL. Is that bad? Is that bad? please contact your police. As many as you can, take the recording of this, the line which is called Truth About Dirk, and those of you who were around him and he worshipped him, now you understand, you become part of a paedophile group without you knowing. Those of you who win that for you to do most of the dirty work, this is all the time, that's what is done. Times are not coincidental. Look at the time in 2000, 2002, when it came into compression, because now murdering scientists was more lubricant and the children were on the sideline, when a scientist was killed in Holland for 100 million. And then you see the fight between the friends and the sharing of the loot. A man who was a what you call a government senior, now became a toy maker, now has become a compression man, and now he's become a scientist in the space and space technology. A chameleon with no knowledge, a hypocrite, a thief, a murderer. DL, you opened the file, you brought your children in writing, not us. You showed how you do operate, not us. And our job was to open your hand, and you walked into it. Disgrace and shame on humanity comes through the man who abused children, and you've done it. You thought you're hiding. You opened the facts about the Keshe Foundation, facts about Mehran T Keshe. We let you write because we knew one day through it, you get so arrogant that you open the truth about yourself. And we have achieved it. We know you're going to write more. We watch every word. Not us, but the security forces are watching. You're opening a lot of things which to us was unbelievable. A man can get so low to harm children. In a way, as I was talking to the security forces in Italy, we said DL is like the hole in the wall in Rome. If you've been to Rome, in center of Rome, there is a hole in the wall, like a head of, it's a knock. And they say you put your hand in the hole, and if you're correct, you can take your hand out. And if you're not correct, the hand will not come out. But in this case, what we said with the security forces in Italy is that DL is sitting on the other side. He only holds the hand of the children, which are 6 and 7 years old, and they cannot go out. And he looks so innocent with the rest. You have to understand, Italian police forces have got a full file on the L, on his attempted, twice attempted murder of my life. That's how they know, and how we are operating and looking at, and the way he's connected to the terrorism. We don't talk about that side. That's for national securities and the government, how they're watching the police of Belgium, operating, collaborating and everything else. Those of you who thought he was innocent and you supported him and you're in contact, touch with the police in Cortec, inform them. The Interpol is watching everything around the operation of the police in Belgium and the others, which is in the hierarchy, protecting people like Dio. You thought you can ransack and rampage and do whatever you like. You thought you can bombard the offices and telephone calls to different governments. We sit with the government security forces because it's our job. Keshe Foundation technology, if it's not connected and corrected with the security forces in the wrong hand, can be abused. So we work closely, we monitor everything. Keshe Foundation, as I said, is one of the very few organizations who has its own internal security. We watch traffic, we watch people who come to harm us, we don't watch for anything else. So now, please, go on Facts About Dirk, and then connect all the dots and cross all the T's, and end up with one man. A paedophile, high-level paedophile, has the audacity to put the condoms he has used. You have to understand why they use condoms, because genetic fingerprinting inside the child after rape can lead to them. Now you understand. Our scientific analysis by the security forces is very detailed. They learned this through one of their bosses with number of cases in raping children, that fingerprint of genetic sperm was left behind, but he's a high level, he managed to protect himself. These guys don't. Now you understand. Now you understand, let him write more. By writing more, he opens more into what we need to know. Please write more. Please write more about and translate from the other papers and everywhere which you think are influential. Soon you'll be knocked on the door. We don't want to do that, then we have to fight. We work on the same basis as we did with FBI, with Sterling. We let you walk out and hand yourself over. But in a way, what you are doing and the people you're in contact and all the hidden communications you think you are doing, you are finding more and more. You have to understand, we share knowledge with securities, and what they find out, they share with us, that we can make sure things and people like you cannot work. We ask you before, please, the other's head of a snake sits in what you call Sierra Leone with Comrade. He works closely with DL. They are in a sick children trafficking, and the company is on the internet. Why should a company employ, unless the company can confirm and show? How come they got rid of him immediately? They found out, we opened their hands. Translating sick children document with the pictures that when they arrive, as they are sick, they are dead. Now you understand why I took so much. I've taken 11 days of imprisonment, being told to be executed every day. What I received daily from the hands of a criminal who's trying to save his neck, writing on the page of the internet, is nothing. And don't forget, he got paid €1 million plus. He bought a house from it, because he was living in a house with full cardboard. For 6 years, I was not allowed to go to his house. I had to wait downstairs. And only person who could go to his room was the paedophile guy who raped the two children in Thailand. They were always together. I had to wait downstairs. I could not, writing patterns. He could come to my house, but I could not go to his. We gathered why there were children upstairs being raped. Why that was a house of criminals. How come a man who says, who writes and so sincere, would not allow a man who he works with into his house, saying the house is full of cardboards and he cannot come in? For 6 years, we could not go to his house, till he received the money from my own imprisonment, bought the new apartment to show me, you see, I got the wealth from yours. And that's the time, for the first time, he saw the children around him. Before that, was not be able to. Now you understand me no more. We know a lot more about this man, now that we sit back and we analyze what he's done. Forget about the talks, get in touch with the police. Don't give up, do not give up. Now we're giving you the lead to work on. There are people who are supporting us. Security forces are putting websites, everything out around DL, is to find out how and how to get into the mind of this Jekyll and Hyde. One of the pictures on this new website shows his pleasure in showing anything to do with penetration, and he speaks about it heavily. The man is sick in the head. How many children you have killed? One child. We ask you only the name of one child. And as you see, he has favorite sizes and shapes. all used. All used. All memory of the children. A sick man. And don't forget, he sells his artwork for $390 to the other paedophiles. Look at the picture. This is his way of working. A beautiful, beautifully laid out card, internet card, invitation for pictures, with one blonde child holding her head. So, he's after blonde girls. But interesting is, we see blonde girls around him a lot in other pictures. Victims. And in another one, we see, he says very thing. It is his innovation again, love, and then he says, fetish, peep, fixation. And this is another product. The same thing as the cube, but this time most probably children in it. The guy is sick. Let us bring this man to prison. Let us take him out, the same we did with Sterling. It's our job. Security services ask you, collaborate with us. Keshe Foundation ask us. Our people ask us, collaborate with us to bring this man and his team to justice. He's sitting in one house, but is well protected by his people. The option is two things for him, and he knows. Now we open the book. I think it's time to eat the carrot of the banana by the man whose mind is only works in one way. Look at the pictures. Please go on this link which is set up called Facts About Dirk. And look at the foot of these children, you see. Is the child still alive? Are those children on the floor still alive? Where are the thousands of children which go missing, trafficked from Africa, Ghana and the other countries, Morocco, into Belgium? And they all end up in Antwerp. And DL lives in Antwerp. Why don't they live in Brussels, Bruges, Liège, Antwerp? Now you understand. I hope you understand. We need to let this man to write more and more, that with his own writing, he comes to justice. It's your job as Keshe Foundation members, to contact the police in every shape or form and tell them why these people are looking for a picture of children, full picture. The ad says, first thing they need is a full body picture. And then they put a picture of a little blonde child. They say they started from 2015-16, but already 2014 been doing it, 2013, this was the best way to capture children. They found the niche, the research and development man, senior man, has found a way to capture children. And with his hypnotism, children never remember. We don't know how many dead. We know the statistic only from UK government, which trafficked to Belgium last year, is 4 children dead. This is the, do not forget, Keshe Foundation works closely with British securities. I have worked with British securities over 30 years. I have a very good reputation and name for what I do, because I've been correct. I don't interfere with politics, I don't interfere into drugs, alcohol or anything else, but through my extensive knowledge of searching and understanding and being in the openness of the world, they understand when the advice is correct. This is a statistics from British government. 4 children trafficked by the direct deed of these people are dead in England alone in 2016. Forget about the others they put into prostitution and the bodies never found. Don't forget the house where he lives is less than 100 meters from the dock. It's strategically chosen that the bodies can be shipped out into the seas. Go and look at the position. We have given you the name of. Now the securities are working at this, why this house was chosen. You are sitting on top of the Antwerp docks and the children are put and disappeared. The bus has a last taste before he changes the color. The sickness of this man is beyond imagination. And he only comes, works, and looks for 2 things. Children, which are connected with him with paedophiles, and scientists like us and the other scientists who've been murdered, and other scientists who's got his black box in the company in Belgium, to use us to gather more money for his masters through using our technologies to get more access, the way Sterling told us. The visitors hungry for new science are young children, and they know it's targeted. Please, please, take this recording. We specifically made this recording today this way, that you can segment it, and with the facts about Dirk, to submit it to the police. Why are they looking for 6-year-old children? Why are they looking for blonde girls? Why are they looking for full body pictures? And they only show their toes. And then, to cover up, they bring their own children. Sterling did. When they found the 2 girls dying of starvation in the Drew's house, most probably Mr. DL has already got a condom. One of them reminds you of that. So, please write, Mr. DL, more about my facts, because you are leading us to where we want. Now, you have confessed to a lot of things which you denied. You're on the top of the paragraph, you have nothing to do, but you say change management. It went where it go, who's the new owner? The picture says. And then, how come if you sold 12 years ago, the new sales marketing manager, you say who it is? And then you confess to it. Now we were looking that you're involved in trafficking, in bringing new R&D, research and develop new ways to bring children in for your masters. There'll be more released. We have connected him to a group in US, a group which is connected to Sterling, and in the hidden conversations, which nobody understands, the word cube is used, they speak about murder, and how one of them was caught, and the others. And this goes back at the same time, 2012, 2014, and the rest of it, and goes back to 2002. The word is the cube. And the murders appeared, and people done in US and other part of the world. You have to understand, this is a new word for them. You heard about the pizza, but you understand now the cube. Cube is for cute children. This is the mentality. When you read all the reports I've read, I receive, you see, now start seeing into the mind of the man. We don't accuse. This is what is written by him. Not us. We haven't added anything into it. We just put the mentality of the man and how he's hidden things and how he's involved. And when we told you he's involved in killing scientists, now you see it. Very simply. Once the collaborator now writes about him, how they cheated each other. And for people like us, opens our eyes that this organization is not only to children, but finances itself through other things. Read the sportsman, press click on it, you see how a man who he worked to write pattern in the morning, when they finish at night writing the pattern, before the man who's supposed to be the owner, there is in the patent office in Belgium, submitting the pattern when it was written somewhere else, but for somebody else. He writes the pattern, I'm too tired to hand it over, I'll do it, I'll finish it tomorrow. He runs into Antwerp, he goes and submits as a pattern for himself. The stealing, killing is part of his. We don't say, read this. A lot of the information is going to be released about the pattern of his work. A lot of it, read it. A lot of it is in writing of his own. A lot is about his own way of working, not us. I thank our research teams. I thank national security, international security who are working with us. I thank especially CIA and Russian intelligence services. I thank Ghanaian security services who work with us. I thank Italian national security at the highest level. Without you, we could not have done. You got to understand one thing, that we share knowledge openly. Whatever we find about these people in a secure way is accessible on a daily basis by Interpol and national securities. We have given them the access code, we have given them everything on secure servers to access all the knowledge. And secondly, if it goes, they've been given in a hard copy. It's our pattern of work. We gave our patents in a USB stick to governments. We give all this information on a regular basis on the USB stick to national securities. This is the Way Foundation. This is how we should be. This is how an organization looks after its children, looks after its science, looks after its technology, understands all the attacks. So, now we know a little bit more about the writer of so much, because he knew we pushed the button in June last year, and he went rampaging because he knew we found out. And now he brought it out, who is and how he works. And he uses his family to bring children, and is under, as he said, on the internet, Facebook friends, but it's a full brush advertising capturing children. Claiming innocent when you're caught. So, what I have to tell is one thing. We are unraveling one of the biggest paedophile networks, which is going over 30 years, headed by DL. Now we have unraveled the way they capture children. Now we unraveled how he has set up an organization with the benefit of claiming being an ex-civil servant, son of a multimillionaire rich man. He fits into what the police and Interpol have been looking for, child trafficking. Governmental influence and elite rich. A boy from Africa who had nothing comes now to be a king of traffickers of children. Please, please, do not stop communication with your police. Do not stop. We're still working, we're still negotiating, we're still being told there will be a ban on Belgium adult men, even maybe their wives, in traveling, because this is the route. We stop terrorists who we said they bomb, now we stop children abusers with their families. Bin Laden didn't work on his own, so do these criminals. Now he has brought the woodwork out into open, we haven't. The new marketing manager, I'm hiding behind what I've abused. I have stood a lot. My family stood a lot. My family is not just Caroline and the boys. It's Rick, it's Vince, it's Stanley, it's Armin and others. We have become one nation, and we make sure as one nation we stop this work. We have spent a fortune trying to protect the foundation, and it damaged us in so many ways financially. But we are out of it, we get out of it. But at least now we are proud to say we got the second biggest paedophile ring on this planet, operating a long time. We got the head snake. It's for us to open it. We are monitoring everything. And those of you who thought you're there, Anti-Keshe Foundation, and we're going to bring it down, you're this and that. Now you know, unless you're a paedophile, how you've been used to damage us by a man who himself is a paedophile. In you damaging the Keshe Foundation, in supporting what is done by a paedophile, does it make you a paedophile? Or unknowingly you've been pulled into something which you were not aware. Like us, we were scientists, they use our technology and then they try to murder us as they've done, and the confessions on this reading of internet read so bad. I read you something. It says, dear DL, if you gave money to get an option concerning DGS technology, he says, concerning all people mentioned in this letter, Hollywood.org, and then it says, if you get money to get an option concerning the technology, please contact. So, you see, everything is possible with this man. Everything is done. He accuses people of the things he does that people cannot see what he's doing. And now we open it up. The whole structure is, we have to work this time together as Keshe Foundation, police forces. You have to bring the Interpol in from your country. You have neighboring countries, Holland, France, Germany, Luxembourg. Have to inform your police forces about this guy. He travels across borders. They bring children for him. He hypnotizes them. This is his job. He's called the hypnotizer. That's why we couldn't find him. He's a hypnotizer. Sick man, shame on you for killing so many children. We don't talk about it. You have written it, not us. I hope the foot of those children we see in the images you have put as a new research and development and fetish are still walking. Because we'll never know their faces, doesn't matter who you bring out to say who they are. I hope the children we see on their back, we don't see their faces, are still walking. They still can say, Mama, I love you. They still remember which village you stole them from Ghana into Belgium. Then we can take them back. Let me explain to you something. why I'm so passionate about child trafficking. I used to be part of the British intelligence services for trafficking. I lived in England for 25, 30 years. As a high-level businessman, we worked with the securities we had to. We became part of the structure of the British security intelligence for other things. And in that process, the British securities opened my eyes to child trafficking. And then through it, through United Nations and our connections, we saw how much finances of the Keshe Foundation, which at that time was me alone, and then United Nations opened up their books to us, are going just to buy back children who have been kidnapped for child trafficking out of Africa and India. British securities opened my eyes to things I didn't want to see, but they said, Mehran, you work with us, you have to understand it. I had to understand a lot. I understood how much of the money given to United Nations is paid to the child traffickers to buy the children, and when they are bought back on annual basis, they don't even remember which village they come from. We can't place them back. We try to put them back into school, there is no name. The child has been taken out so young and kept to be trafficked at a certain time, not fed, just enough to walk to get reach to destination to be abused. So many children, I stood in the airport, I stood in Port of Dover with security people telling me, Mehran, that child in that arm is not a child, she's not the mother. Small DNA test, blood test showed, coming from Antwerp. You heard of donkeys, drug trafficking donkeys, where people eat and drink drugs and whatever they do, and then they split it out when they arrive at destination. They are paedophile donkeys. The child is kept with a woman for days, that she, the child sees and is told, if you talk whatever they do to them, cross the borders, on the plane, on the ships, they deliver at the destination, they get paid the ticket to get to Europe, they get their child. It's the same from Romania, it's the same from Bulgaria, it's the same from Eastern Bloc, it's the same from China and Africa. Go on a childless trafficking of British intelligence report. Number of children. Everything which arrived in UK, there is a hidden chart report which is kept on a daily basis by United Nations. Shows how many children are in traffic at any time United Nations knows, but they can't, what they have to buy ticket. It's a big operation, child trafficking, for the sick people like the young. And when they don't get, they have to advertise to get locally. The strange thing is, we have a very good friend in Belgium. He knows who he is. He took me to a nurse, and I've said this before, and she said to me, Mehran, help us, these people, in the name of even religion, are raping children. And children are committing suicide, and they remember what they've done. Paedophilia is a huge business. I had to stand with the United Nations officers, I had to stand with the customs officers. Unknowingly, I had to sit and eat with one of the biggest criminals in child trafficking, thinking he was brought to us, that he helps us, but he was helping himself through his pants, through the service of the Keshe Foundation and the others, for the children. as much as I teach science, as much as I teach how to get man to space, I have to make sure that these people don't get into space. What would be our future in space if we have these people and they want to taste the new child of the man from another planet? Mayhem for us. Now, let us work and bring this man into justice. We don't say anything. He's his own writing, his own website, his own artwork, not us. We just unravel the puzzle. Now the pieces of puzzle are put cubically together to find out to cube the man who was the inventor of the puzzling cube. The puzzle is the child and the cube is the prison for him till they finish using the condoms. Facts about Dirk will get thickened because we have so much to show you how he's connected with our scientists, how he's connected with other things. This site doesn't belong to me. They send it to me, I'll read it to you the way you read facts about Mehran T Keshe. I'll read you what is written facts about Dirk. Now you understand how suddenly in past 12 months, we have become a target when we picked up one of the most profitable lines for them, which was Sterling. We damaged the purse very badly, so they had to take revenge. The boss was losing money, so he took control himself. And now, those who go on his website has the same position as Sterling, knowing who they are, what they are, and they have chosen a pattern that when you come and talk on the Keshe Foundation, or you show something, or you want to do something with the Foundation, they find your email, they attack you, they threaten your children. These people have no teeth. Don't get worried about them. Come back and show your inventions, show your research. You have enlightened a lot of people. These people have made the threat a lot. They're all in two countries, three countries. They sit in Austria, Luxembourg, Germany and Belgium. And they're all controlled, they're the slaves of DL. But he touches them in different way. And we have seen what has happened. Please cut this section and give it to the police, your local police. Start with your local police, go and say this is on the internet. This guy what he's doing, advertising for children, pictures of the children. And then give this teaching, translate this. Now this section is transcribed. Say to your police, listen to this. Where are our children? Why is this man can advertise for children? You don't ask for a child for goodness sake and just show his feet and then write in another passage the fetish. And then put line of condoms. Sick man. We don't preach. We inspire for you to stop the rest. This thing will not stop. Somebody else will take his place. But he's such a key man that we can delay it. Look at it one thing. I was explaining this to security people very recently. We got Sterling. Through the other connections with the Interpol, we got 70,000 which are on the list. 4,000 have been arrested. If these 4,000 would have raped or whatever or abused one child a year, that's 4,000 children. If they would have done once every 10 years, that's 400 children a year. That's one child a day. Damaged beyond. And this is in one organization centered in Belgium. Read all the national security reports about child trafficking, Antwerp is mentioned on it. Antwerp is the center of child trafficking headed by DL. He's part of the management. He's the oldest hand. he has happily cube business. The cube is the coffin of the child, that's what it means. You will see in the site, in the coming times, when we show you how the cube works and how they confess murdering, as I said before. Thank you very much for your time. As much as I teach you science, this is the second time I put everything online. We got the Sterling, now we got to get Dirk. He's confessed to it. When you lie, means you're caught, and you have to lie, and one after another in three paragraphs. We couldn't get him writing, now he's written. Don't forget, he confessed, he pissed in the garden, and he's the children pictures in the garden. Now you understand. Okay, let us go to our teaching. The teaching is very important for us. Today, we have time, a little bit more time left, not much, about teaching in respect to the space technology.